Okay, another quick clip. I'm standing at the road where my driveway goes into the house there, you can see. And we'll slowly pan around. Uh-oh, look at there. And that's the dirt road that I live on. And my property, this is across the street. And basically, down there you can see the light pole and a little orange thing sticking up. That is the front edge, the southern edge of my property. And it goes all the way here to the driveway. There's my house. That's all my property. And it goes down there to, there's an orange stake sticking up. So that's the end of it. And there is a neighbor right there. But look at the mountains. Oh, yes. See, all that junk, it'll pay off. Who gets to live out in the middle of nowhere like this with electricity and internet and water? And I'm a lucky guy. A lot of work. And I wish I was younger and more able, but I'll do what I can. Oh, hey, another birdhouse. See now, I love birdhouses. And Jamie from Gilbrook Farm just built one, and the video was, by the time you see this, a few days ago, but so that's like 4 birdhouses I've seen on the property. Anyway, and this is a shed out by the road, structurally falling apart, but there is some, metal that can be used for all kinds of stuff. But, all kinds of emotions and thoughts going through my head. And basically that direction, at the end of my property, I'll walk back down here. Okay. Yeah, that light pole. And then across the street from that light pole is the Ouachita National Forest. So, in the direction that my camera is pointed, I don't have neighbors for miles and miles and miles. And I've got that view. So this is where I would turn left into my driveway, and that will be what I'm looking at. Okay, folks. Not windy today. I could sure use some wind, but always use a wind filter. Oh, here's a sign. What's this? Skunk crossing. Great. And now I'm gonna walk down here. Might as well. This is the front edge of my property, and this is I don't know what any of these things are, but as you can see, there's a lot of sun. I put a row of cut flowers all the way down from that light pole along the street and just do a row of cut flowers. And that's one idea anyway. Lots of ideas. Here's a little, foot high rock wall. That's very interesting. And I've got a feeling we're going to find those all over the place. But yeah, there's a little rock wall. And looks like an opening in there. And you can see that shed in the background. And this looks like the lowest point. Well, maybe not. One of the lower points on the property. That'd be a good place to stick a, you know, an RV or a shed. Probably have to clear out those rocks to get it in there, but that's a perfect big enough spot for a shed. And that thing lying on the ground is an old basketball hoop. But I just, man, I wish I knew the history of this place. But, I'll just make it up. Make my own. Especially this rock wall, it goes all the way down here. And a lot of cutting. This is all still my property. And yep, basically this buried telephone cable. See, that's how I'm getting high speed internet. They are running fiber out here. And there's the electric pole. Not in phase. Optic cable warning. Buried fiber optic cable. Gotta love that. There's a neighbor there. That's the Wachita National Forest. And I'm standing at the corner here. That's my road. You can see my drive going off to the left. And it goes back from here about 462 feet. And it goes this direction 264 feet. Rectangular. There is a house back in there, and that's brand new. I guess they're just, it's like a cabin. They only come for the weekends. And there's a neighbor there that you can't see it on Google Maps, but pretty cool little place. I don't know if anybody lives there full time or not. Probably not. Don't see any cars or anything. I'll find out soon enough. Man, I'm anxious to get down here and get started now. So anxious to get started. What is that? Boundary. Oh, maybe that's my boundary. No, I don't think there's any disputes. But still, it's... But, okay, so maybe it's 462 feet straight back from that boundary pole. And then 264 feet down there to that orange, just to the left of the road. That'll be my property. Yeah, that's my property. That is a cool looking, not very functional, but it looks cool. And this road goes down. There's one house over right here to the right. I showed you that. And then there's down this road, there's just one more house. Anybody want to ID any of these plants and tell me if they're worth anything. But I'll keep walking down here to the... Okay, this is my property on the front. I do know what pine trees look like. And that's a new place. It's so new, it's not even on Google Maps yet. Okay, and here you can see this cattle gate. This is the end of my property. And when I came out here to look at it, he had one bull out here. And here's the fence. My property line is about right there. And let's see if we can get across here. Maybe show it to you from the side. Yep. The tree line is, my property goes 462 feet back there. And you can see the top, that's an old mobile home. The windows and doors aren't even on it. It's just, but I walked all the way back there and then over when I looked at it. But look at this field that's just sitting there, not doing anything. Can you say rent a couple acres for cheap and run some chicken tractors, maybe an eggmobile, split the profits? No, just rent the land from the owner and keep the profits for myself. If they're not doing anything with it, at least make some money. Ideas. A lot to do before I get to that point. Okay, signing off. This is like going to be the longest tour ever, but if I don't share it, at least I'll have it for posterity.